I'm really digging this style quite a lot. I'm gonna tell you that. Upload on Mondays, Thursdays, and Fridays, and I also do like to throw in surprise uploads. That is why you need to subscribe so you won't miss any of them. Just join the party by clicking that button down below. If you have already subscribed, thank you so much. I greatly do appreciate it. I am going to be bringing you a wig review today. She's not a new drop, but I also do love those oldies but goodies, so as I always do, I'll tell you everything about her. Please give me your respectful feedback in the comments, and if there's a wig you'd like me to review, just let me know and I'll try to make it happen for you. But real quick, just wanted to let you know that I might, and I emphasize the word might, be taking a short temporary break. I am moving in a couple of weeks, so scrambling to get everything done here and then have to get settled into the new place will take up some time. I do, however, pre-film, so I've got some videos already in the tank that hopefully will take care of my schedule moving forward, but just in case those run out, you know why. But be prepared, it's only going to be temporary, so nothing to worry about there. But let's get to talking about this girl here, and today I have got Janet Collection in the style Mia. She has a lace front from the Color Me collection. I have her in the color O.AUTUMN Orange. She has a lot of beautiful colors that she's available in. I know it's really small here, but it's written on the bottom of the stock card. As I like to always point out on the stock card, it does say fashion fantasy hair color, so you've got some really beautiful color choices here. She has a 6-inch deep part and is heat safe up to 360 degrees Fahrenheit. I picked her up from Sam's Beauty for $21.99. This is Miss Mia. And for the lace here, let's take a look at that. It is darker shaded, as you can see there, but I still think it's transparent. I can probably still work with that. I see some baby hairs as well. Flipping her inside out, we have got one comb in the back, adjustable straps, mesh lining. She has got that 6-inch parting space right there. And then she's got one comb on each side of the part. Stretchability is really good. Wow, look at that. Oh, yeah. I'm thinking she's going to be larger head friendly. I'll let you know for sure, though, after I have her on. And I'm going to go do that right now, so I'll be right back. All right, I am back with Mia. Look at this. Just look at these waves. This is a gorgeous pattern. It looks natural. I'm really digging this style quite a lot. I'm going to tell you that. And I actually was contemplating saving her for the fall because of her colors, but you know what? I'm wearing fall colors in the summertime, and people still have this color year-round for their hair, and I figured, what's the big deal? Let's just do it now, and I'm really glad that I decided to wear her today because she is so beautiful. I love this color quite a lot, too. As I mentioned, the Color Me collection is really good at making these beautiful colors, and it starts out with the darker root, but it's not real harsh because it's more like a gradient effect, how it starts out darker and then gets lighter. So to me, this looks more natural, or actually more professional, really. And you have the different tones and highlights in here with this beautiful coppers. I am loving it. And look at the ends, how it's much brighter down there. This is a very, very beautiful color. I think they did a great job of blending, really nice tones, mixture of the tones, I mean. So happy, very happy with this color. And she's got really good luster too. It looks like natural, healthy hair to me. Her texture is another one that I actually do like quite a lot. It's light yakky, which happens to be my all-time favorite texture. It feels more closest to my own natural hair. So I feel some silkiness in there, not a lot, just a little tiny bit, but enough to make it feel very soft. And then you do have some of that coarseness in there too. So it's a really good mixture of the two to make this hair feel realistic, and is definitely a good multicultural texture. Be prepared though, this girl is long. Let me stand up here. I know we probably can't get all of it in the frame, but I'm 5'5" and she's like right down to here on me. So I'm gonna say probably 28 inches, right around there. She's got a little bit of layering here, but even those are still on the longer end. And even though she is very long, she's got amazing density. Look at that, she's not like super full or anything. This looks more natural this way, and it just kind of drapes down over you, and that I do like. So as far as tangling goes, look at this. Look at this. Oh my gosh, this surprised me. With this length, I would have thought I would have gotten a lot of tangles, but no. Sirree, look at that. The tangles I do get, boom, come out so quickly and easily that I don't think it's going to damage this hair at all. This is a style, once again, that I am not using a brush or comb on. I don't think you really need to anyway, because look at this. Just your fingers is all you need to do. And then that way you're also keeping this really pretty wave pattern the natural way it is intended to be. So I would recommend just using your fingers for her. So she's actually really easy to manage, which surprised me based on this length. So those that do like longer hair could probably get away with wearing her to work, and if you're on the go, because you don't have to worry about her becoming a tangling mess. Shedding isn't bad either, nothing excessive there. So let's go ahead and take a look at her from the side and the back. I think she looks very pretty that way too. So today I probably am going to wear her down the back. That's just my preference for this style. And I did mention in the intro that she has a 6-inch parting space. Normally I'm not a big fan of the super deep parts, but it's not bad actually. I was afraid it was going to go back to here, but it stops right here. And it's a good depth and width. I didn't have to do any plucking. I only needed to put one coat of powder on, so she blends really well and she lays really flat. So even though she has the darker shaded lace, it was still easy peasy to blend. And she's also got some baby hairs right there, which I like baby hairs right by the part, because when you part your own natural hair, you usually have a little bit of baby hair. So to me, that looks much more natural. She's got really decent sides, not too bad a lift up. They are not pre-plucked, but for units that aren't pre-plucked, this is what I'm looking for. Easy to blend. You got those baby hairs here too. So this doesn't look bad at all. Not at all. Let me see if you can even tuck her. I didn't try to do that. No, probably not. So I usually do those types of things before I film, but I took a chance. The ear tabs are still right where they should, but you can see here if I try to tuck, I'm lifting that up a little bit too much and that's getting in the way. But that's okay. This is a style that looks just fine without being tucked anyway. I do like it. She's fitting really comfortably. She's got great stretchability, and I had to take the adjustable straps pretty tight to get her to fit well. So I am saying without a doubt that she is larger head friendly. I love this unit. And she was, what did I say, $21.99, and then just a little bit for tax and shipping. That is really worth it for this wig. You get a lot for a small amount of money, and she is highly worth every penny. So I am giving her the thumbs up. I love this unit. Highly recommend that you get her too. I would love to know your thoughts. Don't forget to tell me in the comments. Let me know if you already have her, and especially if you decide to get her after watching this review, I want to know that too. And that is all I've got to say about Miss Mia today. I thank you so very much for watching, and I'll catch you all next time. So until then, bye-bye.